Experiencing cloudy skies, snow and blowing snow across the region, and frigid temperatures continuing to work their way in. Let's take a look at the current temperatures around the region. So we're near 5 below zero from Broken Bow Imperial out toward Lexington and North Platte. 1 degree right now at Lexington, but closer to 10 below zero at Thedford and at Valentine. There's your winds. They have picked up. Right now, sustained in most places, 25 to 35 miles per hour, an extremely cold northerly direction. And winds are gusting right now, 35 to 45 miles per hour, strongest wind gust off to the south of I-80. So that's causing some blowing of the snow that's falling. We do have a visibility of 2 miles at North Platte, but as you make your way into the sand hills up toward Valentine, even Broken Bow, less than a mile visibility out in that direction. So definitely be aware of that. Now let's take a look at those wind chill values. Wind chills right now from North Platte up toward the Valentine area between 30 and 40 below zero. Feels a little warmer out toward Lexington with a wind chill of only 24 below zero. So this is the extremely frigid air we've been warning about. Wind chill warning for the entire viewing area goes all the way until noon central time on Saturday. And because of the snow and blowing snow, the entire viewing area also in a winter weather advisory that does go until 6 a.m. central time on Friday for the slippery roads and the reduced visibility. Let's take a look at the Doppler radar across the region. The heaviest and steadiest snow has been into the sand hills up toward Valentine. They had some snow squall warnings. One of them just expired at 6:15. Central time. That's going to move off to the east. Here in the North Platte area, I-80 corridor, we've struggled to get a lot of snow. It's been blowing around, reducing the visibility, but not a lot of accumulation. This system has very little moisture with it. We have another couple bands of snow to get through, and then the system will be over except for the cold. So here's a look at the surface map across the country. So the low has moved off to the east. We really did not get into that warm sector like we thought. Did make it 25 degrees today, but this cold front made its way through. And there's the door open right to the Arctic with just a little bit of snow on the backside. Now we have a system here across the southeast. That's sapping the moisture away, but these two are going to combine to become a major system into the Midwest and Northeast. We're just going to get the extremely cold air from this one. So as we make our way through the rest of the evening, the snow actually should start to taper off. Still got a few more hours to go, especially south of I-80 has some snow, but by around 11 p.m., current temperature between 7 and 15 below zero, and then starting off the day tomorrow, between 16 and 23 below zero, but mainly cloudy skies, good amount of sunshine tomorrow, highs only around 4 degrees below zero, and then we fall back down into the freezer with lows between, say, 10 and 15 below zero, starting off your Friday morning. A lot of sunshine on Friday, finally trying to get that wind to flip around to the west. We warm up just a little with highs into the mid to upper single digits. As for the snowfall from this one, not expecting a lot. When all is said and done, this is going to be hard to measure once again because of the blowing snow, but we think that the area is outlined in light blue, additional snowfall of 1, maybe 2 inches. Don't think that anybody's really going to see 3 inches from this one, but we think the main threat is going to be the wind and the reduced visibility. High tomorrow of 3 below zero, another weather alert day for extreme cold. Breezy to windy through Friday, a high of 10, lots of sunshine, lower 20s on Saturday, then highs in the lower 40s Sunday and Monday with partly to mostly cloudy skies, and lower 50s Tuesday and Wednesday as we warm up, mostly sunny to partly cloudy skies. Kent?
Thanks, Justin. And coming up, it's the first national signing day for Division I football players across the country. Lindsay has a look at a player.